Hello and welcome to Oxmond tutorials. This tutorial is the most basic tutorial of all tutorials. Let's move a cube with the arrow keys. Let's begin with an empty scene. Change the background color of the camera to just pure black. Now create a 3D cube and we have to rescale it something like 10 and 1.5, 0.5 and 10. We have to adjust a little and then rename it to ground. Got it round. Now let's make another cube. This one should be fairly small, something like 1 and 1 and 1. And just drag it a little bit up. Maybe move it a little bit closer to the camera. And now create a new material. We will just rename that material for blue and we'll select a nice blue color. Drag the material to the cube and move the cube a little bit up. We would like to add some gravity and we do that by adding a rigid body component. Make sure that the use gravity is selected. Let's test the scene. Works fine. So let's move the cube down again. Now it's time for some scripting. Create C# script and call it for cube. Drag the script to the cube and double click on the script to open Visual Studio. We don't need the first part of the script, so we just delete that. To move the cube, we use the transform.translate command. It goes like this, transform.translate. And then we have to define a 3D vector. The first value is x, we set that to 0.1. And the two next values we set to 0 and 0. Let's have a look at how it works in Unity. Oh no, the cube died. Anyway, the animation works fine, so now we have to add the keyboard control. We can use the input.getAxis command for that. Input.getAxis and horizontal, and we have to multiply that with time.deltaTime. This is to make sure that it will run at the same speed on every computer. And again, we have to multiply that with some kind of speed. I prefer a value about 15, but you can, of course, change that. Let's have a look back in Unity. I use my arrow keys left and right, and it just works perfect. Press D to copy the line we just made. And now we have to move the input to the C axis. And we do that just by strictly copy and paste. But we have to change the word horizontal to vertical. Let's have a look in Unity again. It works like a dream. I have full control over the cube now. Let's make a little game. We could create some enemies. Let's create a new cube at the same size, and we could make a new material, and this one we call red, and we find a nice red color for that, like that, and drag the new material to the new cube. We can move it a little and press Ctrl D to duplicate the cube and move it, the new cube, to the other side. Now let's add some rigid bodies to the new cubes and just check that gravity is still on. Let's play. We go directly for the kill. Kill, 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 die. Wow! It could be really nice if the camera was following the character. We can do that just by dragging the camera to the cube. And now let's play again. Sneaking up behind you and die. Wah! Anyway, that's enough for today. See you soon to another Unity tutorial. Have fun.